activist, writer, and founder of the Srishti Madurai LGBTQIA plus student and romantic orientation is a Buddha. So, first I should accept myself, who I am, the very kind of war within me, the two faces in me. So, then it's about the society. So, if I'm not accepting who I am, the society will not accept what I am. I'm not affiliated to any NGO. And even contested in an election as a first intersex candidate. I funded my own election campaign. So, the thing is, my question is, LGBT individual, is it a necessary individual should be affiliated to an NGO or a non-governmental organization or any organization which receives funds? No. So, it's about creating awareness, reaching the very kind of unreached spaces. And the word they use is advocacy. For advocacy, we don't need money. We need heart and clarity on the subject. And we need to create change makers and evangelize LGBTQIA+ issues to create awareness. I don't know how far we are, you know, progressive on that. And a country like India, with so much diversity, even with its own gender, sex, and you know, sexual minority identities, it's like, you know, very hard to put forth the very kind of struggle there. So, more except three countries, all other countries in the world, it's like saying that you should only live as male or female or trans, not as an intersex person. So, who is this government to tell me about my body? So, in a search of where I live in my body, I explore it through my gender and sexual and sex identity, that stuff. My gender, sex, sexual orientation is just one aspect of my life, but it's not all about my life. And I don't know why people claim on, you know. Yeah, I was born as an intersex, and I'm a genderqueer person and an aromantic gay. But it's not necessary for me to have an affiliation with an NGO, non-governmental organization, or some kind of groups. So we are the longest floating student volunteer movement in India, which reach the unreached spaces. So I have the privilege, and I'm representing those who don't have the privilege, the voices unheard. So people are here from Canada. Canada is part of Commonwealth. under this particular draconian colonial law, IPC 377, which is not directly referring to homosexuality but to unnatural sex, a Christian law, is part of most of the Commonwealth nations. I wish Canada should work on it. Day-to-day life in non-metropolitan cities is something, you know, it's not easy for us. And when someone organized some national level meeting in India, or it only happens in metropolitan cities. We never bother about two-tier cities. I always say Madrid is not Spain. Chennai is not Tamil Nadu, or Delhi is not India. So, a wider range of engagement. And we need to engage all those unreached people, and we need to find out the strategy to do that. And it should come from the advocacy group, not affiliated with any non-governmental organizations, or, you know, because these NGOs failed to educate the policymakers, the lawmakers, in India especially. They didn't achieve anything. What we achieved in the past 7 years, without a single penny, no one funded us. They failed to achieve. We don't know what crores of money, where it went to. So we are sitting in a beautiful AC-packed hall. Meanwhile, you know, every year 10,000 newborn intersex babies are dying in India. So where I get the census from? Doctor themselves are telling what they are doing to the newborn babies. Newborn babies cannot come with the rainbow flag and, you know, protest on the street. So first I should talk about the discrimination within the community. I'm not discriminated by someone who is on the road, a public. All these NGOs failed to educate the people within the community about the diversity within the community. We talk a lot about diversity, but we forget the diversity within our community. Everyone has their own gender pronouns. When they have the gender pronouns are created to break the heteronormative structure of this stupid society. You know, when someone is addressing me as something else in which I don't want to be, I feel like I'm on fire. So, and also we need to engage differently abled and physically challenged intersex people and asexuals. We don't have space for physically challenged and differently abled people in India or in developing nations or underdeveloped nations. I have hands, mouth to talk, but those who don't have that, what these NGOs did to them and how they reached them. I'm not only questioning them, I'm working for it, so I'm questioning it. I'm working without a penny from all of these people, and I have all the right to question them, I believe. And I'm trying to create a strategy through working through schools. I'm working in such a space, I'm talking about sex, gender and sexuality. I got banned by many government institutions, which these NGOs never tried to do that. So pride parades and these beautiful segments and meetings are not everything. Last year, in my own community, 5 people died, and 1 girl, trans woman, was burned to death by the Hijra Guru. The case was filed, but no action was taken. Where were these NGOs? Where were these NGOs? In the national level meeting, they were pleasing the UNAIDS fund for more than decades. They are using HIV fund for LGBT activism. I'm not against HIV people or anyone. It needs to be inclusive. But the steps are not constructive at all. They cannot get some funds for something and use it for something else. Making trans women to supply condom, distribute condom on the middle of the streets in India in the name of project intervention, a targeted intervention, is such a stupid thing. And no transgender bill law which was passed in India went against or questioned the very kind of human rights why women, I need to pay tax to my guru. So this particular girl whom we rescued from forced sex work in India, she was like 2 years begging to the guru, that elder person, the trans woman, and she was like telling, oh, now you underwent operation, so you look like a woman and you bet and gave the money. So now you do go to hammam and do sex work daily. They need to meet at least four to five people, you know, customers. And all the money will go to, there's a big mafia working on behind this indigenous gender minority identities in India. None of the NGOs dare to question it, because if they question it, all the HIV funds will be stopped. I questioned it, they asked me to remove my trousers to prove whether I'm an intersex person. So let us first start with educating our own community about all the diversity in the community. Let me not club up all the different identities as one. We are here to, you know, challenge the rules and always to be in the out of box. If something is in order, we should question it. But because there is nothing called in order. But then we are trying to homogenize our own community, our diverse identities are hidden. I'm telling this with a pain. Thank God I not operated as something else in my childhood because of my maternal grandmother. With all struggle, I never share sympathetic stories about myself anyway. I'm here as an intersex person, and there are thousands and thousands of intersex people are living around the globe like me. So give a space to them. Give a space to them. Create a space to them. So we need to define and differentiate the identities first. What is what? In India we talk a lot about, but we don't know who are transgender people. For them, transgender means only trans women, and that too indigenous Hijra or Arwani, not trans women. So many of the trans women don't want to identify with Hijra community there, and we do, even though I don't know, and we have trans women who are senior officials, bureaucrats, but for intersex people, they are misidentifying them as sometimes as trans women too. That's wrong, but we are working on to define and differentiate the identities. So let me end with this. So commercialization. I'm an individual, and let me be an individual. So if I'm an LGBT person, it's not necessary for me to have an affiliation with an NGO to recognize what I am and who I am. So let me first educate the community about the diversity, then we will go to the society and educate. Thank you.
Contarle a Maurice y a todos que nosotros en el proceso de aprobación de la ley del matrimonio igualitario en Argentina trabajamos con todas las religiones, y por primera vez en el año 2010 sacerdotes católicos, apostólicos romanos en ejercicio se expresaron públicamente a favor, con imanes, con rabinos, con pastores evangélicos. Se logró eso que vos decías de buscar los aliados y mostrar que también para las religiones también es compatible la diversidad sexual. Esto otro tiene que ver con algunos factores de poder con los cuales hay que luchar de la mano de todos estos sectores que vos decías que existen y que creo que es una de las armas más poderosas, ¿no? Pegar ahí en ese poder reaccionario que tienen algunas religiones justamente desde adentro con los sectores que son más abiertos.
Thank you.
Small point to it, is, there comes also politicizing the cause, you know. So most of the governments are interconnected to the religion, you know. In India, we take oath on constitution, but it's in even it's completely different. And also, we most of the LGBT movements are projected in a very leftist manner, where the right government is not comfortable, and they are now recently coming with their own notions on. We had a very kind of Olympian turned homophobic trans person supporting Trump in his campaign, which she had her own, backlash then. But it's about, again, diversity then, you know. It's not about politicizing the cause. Engaging with the politicians are different, and religious teachers and all those people are different, but you know, we should not. Engaging with the politicians and religious leaders is different than politicizing and giving a religious color to the cause. So we need to be very careful in that, because it's for the humanity, it's not for a particular political ideology or a religion, or that's something we need to carefully work on with. Because many individuals who identify with a particular identity, then it brings the very kind of, then you're kind of not differentiating ourselves from the rest of the humanity. So because of the identity, we are identified with. So there starts the problem. So we should not politicize and give a religious color, but without giving that, we should engage the politicians and religious leader, and we should have a strategy to do that.
I know we are all tired, so thank you very much for hanging out and staying on. You have.